Hello there, welcome back to Let's Play the Book of Unwritten Tales 2. I'm the RPG chick. Okay, we finished looking around here. We have to stop him from eating the notebook so that we could call him and help us with the unruly classroom. But I don't know what's to do in here, so let's see if we can...
I don't know much about the history of magic. I wanted to read a book about it, but I couldn't find anything relevant in the whole school.
Okay, I wasn't asking about that. I was just going to have you go back out there and see what items we could use to feed this guy with.
I can't go back out there until I know
okay,
the name of
okay,
the
then that's...
great crab and, thingy. My students would lose all respect for me. And how would I teach them anything then?
By bashing it over their head. Take the food.
Okay, fine. One more time. I give you proper food, and you give me my... Ouch! Okay, fine. And now... You can't always just take in a friendship, you know?
So what are we supposed to do? Oh, put the food on the bed, maybe?
Maybe I can lure Fridlin away from my notepad.
That's a good idea.
That's it. That's all there is. Hey, Fridlin, look! Food! All you have to do is hop over here and get it. Wow! My rabbit shoot has superpowers.
What?
But now the food is gone and Fridlin is still hungry. Ah, no wonder I didn't do it right. It says... space-saving instant dry food. Soak in water before feeding. Ah, crap.
Mm. We have water. Take the water inside yourself.
How about some water to wash the food down? That's what I thought. Food was pretty dry, right? See how well I take care of you? Then maybe we could talk about my notebook. Oops. I'll read the instructions next time, promise. Sorry.
Well, whatever works. Roll on, buddy. That. Nibble notepad.
It says, Master Marcus, only in emergencies. 64179. This is definitely an emergency. I'm losing my students' respect before I even had it.
Huh. Can't lose something you never had. Now can we use this? I'm gonna see Master Marcus.
Well,
where's the numbers?
9. Hopefully this will work this time.
Yes? Hello?
Master Marcus!
Wilbur, what is it?
Get off this line. My students are always asking me questions.
Ah, you have to help me, Master Marcus. The students, they're always asking me questions.
Of course, you're their teacher.
But I don't know the answers. I've only been a teacher for a few days and I'm all alone. And the school is eerie and there's no textbooks and no one wants to learn anything. And...
Wilbur, no one expects you to be the perfect teacher right away. Wake your students' enthusiasm for magic. That would be a good start.
I think the students expect that. Why do I have to teach her all alone? Where are the other teachers?
Why do I have to teach her all alone? Why aren't there any other teachers?
Echo.
Many mages died during the war. There are only a few of us left. And most of those who survived are now pursuing more lucrative activities. Alchemy, ghost hunting, children's birthday parties.
But training new mages is important. If the rest are just out for the gold, then who will take care of the next generation?
Being a teacher is an important and honorable task, Wilbur, even when others fail to appreciate that.
Why aren't you teaching at this school?
If it's such an important task, why aren't you teaching at this school?
Politics. My brother is the Archmage, and he's in the middle of an election campaign. If he were to give his own brother a job, well, his opponents would just love that. But I'm not angry. I did my part. I trained mages when no one else would. And I found the most talented gnome mage the world has ever seen.
I'd like to really inspire my students, but how do I do that?
You said I should inspire my students, but how am I supposed to do that? I don't know anything about the history of magic.
Obviously not, otherwise you would know that you'll never attract anyone with that subject.
But it's in the curriculum.
Oh, bugger the curriculum. Do what you're good at. Cast spells. Fill them with wonder. Make them want to be able to do the same.
But I don't know how.
He doesn't know how.
Wilbur. Conjured a sheep out of a hat, and you didn't know how to do that either.
Yes, so he doesn't know
Go
how to repeat it.
Knock them dead. Let the magic do the work. You may not know what you're doing, but you're doing it.
Just do some magic.
Just do some magic.
Yeah, but you can't teach anybody if you don't know how to say, well, this is how I did it. I really do have a talent for magic, don't I?
Your brother called me a natural talent. I am really quite good at magic, right?
You did some incredible things during your training.
I just wish I could control the magic better. Sometimes it just bubbles out of me, and other times, nothing.
I think that will come with time. And if not, you will have to rely on your ingenuity.
So apparently there was once a great dragon and a gnome?
Apparently there was a powerful gnome mage a long time ago. Did he kill any dragons?
According to legend, the last of the great dragons, Grema, was defeated by a gnome.
That's the one I mean. What was that gnome's name?
No one knows. He arrived at a time of great need and saved the people of the Southlands by accomplishing the impossible. Then he disappeared without a trace.
Wow. But one of my students asked me for his name.
Then he probably wanted to lead you up the garden path. Some students want to find your weaknesses and see how far they can go. Don't take any guff.
Thanks for your help, Master Marcus. I'll get through the lesson one way or another, and now I'll get back in touch, okay?
Sorry, but no, Wilbur. You caught me packing. I'm off to spend two exciting weeks with a couple of friends.
What, you got on vacation? Well, now?
Maybe it's more than just a holiday. I sold the mage school, as you know. I want to start something new. Finally do what I really want to do. Role-playing games.
Haha, now we're talking.
Role-playing games?
Live role-playing games. They start in a few days. Oh. We leave the normal world of magic, monsters, and dungeons behind and immerse ourselves in a fantasy world.
He's going LARPing as human beings.
He's caught in a traffic jam with his truck and must therefore spend a night in a motel.
Huh.
Can you imagine what adventures could be waiting there for me?
Yeah, unfortunately.
I thought being a teacher was really important, and...
That it is! Have fun!
Aunt Marcus! Hello!
Oh. Boop! Well...
Master Marcus told me everything I need to know. Hold your head high. Inspire your students and don't let things get you down. I just wish I wasn't entirely on my own.
Right.
Master Marcus told me everything. The way he looks at the moment, he could give Bertram, the world's fattest hamster, a run for his money.
Oh yeah, that hamster.
He'll get back to normal. A short nap and he'll be right as rain.
The hamster from the first game. Well, that's it. Alright, so we're back out there.
Come on, Wilbur. You can do it. You can inspire your students.
Keep your guard up.
That's better.
So what about the magic runes?
No one knows the name of the gnome that defeated Grandma. Nice try. Feet off the desk. or I'll make it bite them off.
Ha ha ha.
Enough with history of magic. Let's cast some spells. Fairy games. Doesn't sound bad, right?
Huh?
Impossible!
Not bad, eh?
Wow!
That is magic. And here you can learn how to control it. That's it for today. Tomorrow we'll do... something else.
Sure class.
Oh, sorry, honey. Get rid of that, will you? I need a word with Mr. Weatherby. Mr. Weatherby. Nice to finally meet you in person.
I wish I could say the same. And you are?
And you are?
How very precious.
Answer my question.
I rather thought it'd be wise to watch out for you, Mr. Weatherbane.
Why watch out for me?
You only play the innocent little country yokel. I always knew that. Your patron, Archmage Alistair, will not win the election against me. Did you know that we're only 3 points behind him in the latest polls?
No, I wasn't aware of that.
We really couldn't give a crap, lady. You shouldn't have shot my fairies.
You shouldn't have just shot my fairy!
Do not underestimate me, Mr. Weatherbane. I am very well aware that those are not fairies.
I call them fairies.
Hobulus Vergastus, flying kobolds. Don't tell me you conjured them up yourself.
I just did.
Yes, I did. All 5 of them.
Amazing. Powerful magic is needed to manifest living creatures.
Thank you.
That is why most necromancers only reanimate skeletons. Dead matter can be much more easily controlled. As of course you know.
Of course, of course.
Or should know.
I do now, Stinker. How may I help you?
How may I help you?
Help me? Ha! One of the Archmage's top men wants to help me.
Okay, what the hell do you want from me?
You know how the game is played, don't you, Withervane?
Game?
What game?
Yeah.
Things are heating up. The House of Cards is starting to collapse. I know it, and Alistair knows it too.
I don't play cards.
Both lie low, waiting for the other to make a mistake. And he has made the first.
Okay. I don't need a house of cards.
I'd rather play solitaire. Or can I just watch?
Great.
Well said, Weathervane. This time, there can be no spectators. Everyone is either for us or against us. This time, it's about the future of this town and the entire country.
You may be confusing me with another magical, magic teaching gnome.
I think you have me confused with someone else.
But you're pretending to be someone else. Just you wait till I'm leader of the Alliance.
The Alliance?
I know who my friends are, and my enemies.
Am I a friend?
So what mistake did Mr. Alistair supposedly make?
What mistake did the Archmage make?
He hired you.
Oh, thanks.
A gnome with a fake diploma issued by none other than the Archmage's brother Marcus.
I earned my diploma honestly. I have passed all 3 of the exams and...
Gnomes know nothing of magic. Everyone knows that. And you've never taught before.
But Archmage Alistair believes in me.
As the head mage, he appoints the professors. But I'm the merchant council leader and I assign the administrative posts.
Okay.
Headmaster Block will reveal your incompetence and the newspapers will report on the Archmage's dubious personnel policy before the election.
Oh, God. Who is the school's new headmaster?
The new headmaster? Who is he?
Horatius Block. A good man, very correct, and very strict.
Sounds delightful.
If he can help this school return to its former glory, I look forward to working with him.
Former glory? This old ruin, it was already run down back in my day. And wherever it was for the last 20 years, it definitely looks like they didn't have any cleaners.
Well, Archmage Alistair is a great man, and my friend. So kindly shove it up your arse.
My friend, Archmage Alistair, is better suited to bring the city and the country back into shape than anyone else.
Oh, you believe that?
Oh, yes, I do.
He's a great mage. Anyone who doubts that is mad. And he was a great leader during the war, most of the time. But what we need now is someone who understands the economy.
And that's you?
I am a rich and successful merchant. I have rich and successful friends. Who could be better suited to making others rich and successful?
Alistair would step down for you if he believed that.
You know what? I actually believe you're right. Strange, isn't it? How little he worries about defending his power.
So I guess it's all been said, hasn't it?
Indeed. You're on a sinking ship, Withermane. I could still be convinced to throw you a life preserver.
I trust the Archmage.
Then, Mr. Withervane, you shall perish with him.
What a sweetie.
Here, elect Cybil Van Buren. She knows how to get it done. Come along, honey. We're leaving.
There aren't any of these in my book of fairy tales, Mama.
I know, honey. Who wants to look at something that ugly?
It's an improvement
can
from looking at your own mother.
Unicorn, or the Cheshire Cat, or the Frog Prince?
Lovely people. Wow, look at all the stuff we have to look at. Let's look at the fish skeleton.
When the school disappeared 20 years ago, obviously no one looked after the animals. Expected consequences, really.
Oh, we can take it? I thought it was like an amber. I guess this is a cage or something.
The whole skeleton, but a sharp pointed bone like this might just prove useful.
It didn't look like he actually took it. Okay, treasure chest?
It appears they wanted to replicate the fish's natural habitat as exactly as possible, including miniature treasure chests, just like the ones frequently found in the sea.
Open.
Hey, some old coins.
Oh, that side's
maybe
broken
open.
One
of my predecessors had a vicious fish guard his retirement fund.
Okay. I didn't see it first. It's actually all jagged. It's broken open. Alright, let's see what we got here. Old coins.
A few old coins. They must have been underwater for a long time. You can hardly see the detail. That's a small bone from the fish in the glass jar. It's very sharp and has a kind of a hook at the end.
Mm-hmm.
The spell worked excellently. Well, you know, even if the fairies do look a bit strange. I think I've summoned enough of them for now, though. Whoever wants to be rich and successful should trust the rich and successful. We know how it's done. Elect Cybil Van Buren. Master Marx's number won't help me anymore. He's probably already on his way to his live role-playing game.
That's so funny, he's doing LARPing.
Folded sheet from a book.
Plants?
Most of the plants have dried up. No one looked after them. Only this plant must have found a water source somewhere. Perhaps one of the windows has a leak.
What was that? It farted.
Maybe it was always a carnivorous plant. But then again, perhaps it adapted to its new environment to survive. Don't worry, little plant. From now on, I'll take care of you. You won't have to go hungry anymore.
Ugh.
That's disgusting. disgusting. Oh, that smells like rotten eggs.
It's a huggy.
Oh, like Grandad whenever he's eating bean soup. I'm gonna hold my nose. That gas smells like, well, you know, gas.
All right, let's look at the table.
This is the desk that Chantal, the daughter of the council leader, and little Timmy share. Hard to imagine two students being any more different. Chantal is only here because of its tradition in her family, and I don't think she really cares about magic or has any real talent for it. Timmy, though, well, he is eager to learn and was so excited the last few days. It's for students like him that we have to get this school back up and running.
But wait, Timmy is at this table. Table flap.
A pencil case. A ruler. Nothing special. This is the desk that's hard to imagine.
Book.
Oh, Chantal forgot her book. Seems to be a book of fairy tales, but one of the tackier kinds.
Tacky?
My dad used to read me fairy tales when I was a kid. The bloodthirstiest, most cruel, creepy, proper fairy tales. I'll just leave it there. Chantal can take it tomorrow.
That's not taking it.
I'll just leave it.
Look at this table.
I don't know who that boy was. He was a right pain in the ass. However, he seemed to understand a great deal about magic. And if I managed to teach him some manners, he could be an excellent student.
Oh. Was there a third kid here? I only remember two of them. Oh.
Generations of students have left their mark, especially in the form of little pictures and sayings carved into wood. Here's a particularly long one. For all drifters and troublemakers, condemned to write the same sentence on the board over and over again, no problem. Cast the automation spell on the piece of chalk, and it does it all the work for you. Bartholomew. Hey, aye, that's cheating. Pretty clever, though. The spell carved into wood down there, I'll just write it down.
Oh, cool. See, that's why it pays to look at everything. So we've got an automation spell.
Why work when you can do magic? The automation spell.
Oh, there's a diagram here? Oh, I see. Chalkboard.
Introduction to magic, sheep breeding and care, statistics. That seems to be some kind of timetable. Well, as long as I'm the only teacher, most of these subjects won't get taught.
Brochures.
I don't think the Archmage even has brochures like these. No posters or town criers or plays. Either he lacks the gold, or he doesn't want to conduct his election campaign in this manner. I don't know exactly why the council leader left the brochures lying here. It was agreed that children can't vote. First, they wanted to base eligibility to vote on size, which of course led a resistance among us gnomes and the dwarves. And then they said weight should be decisive. The more you weigh, the more weighty your vote. But then the trolls and ogres would have been overrepresented. In the end, they agreed on a minimum age. However, there are still arguments because rats, undead children, and other minorities can never vote.
Undead children. Let's look at the oven.
The last time a fire burned in this was before the school disappeared 20 years ago. And even if I could, I shouldn't start a fire in it anyway. The flue was broken, and the smoke would fill the entire classroom. Some unburned waste. Here's a sheet of paper. Another book page. Or, more precisely, another folded sheet of paper upon which four pages have been printed. When I look at the page numbers on the first sheet and on this sheet, it seems there are at least five sheets missing.
Oh, wait. Sorry. Hit the wrong thing.
Where there are two pages to be found, there are sure to be even more. Based on the page numbers, I would say that there must be at least five more sheets.
Hmm. Close. Okay.
The mixing of portions is an important part of magic. It's a bit like cooking, except a stew doesn't kill you if you add the wrong ingredient. Or if it's stirred wrong.
Mm-hmm.
No? With a little luck, I can get through the day without causing an explosion. Looks like someone wanted to start a fire and burn the book pages. Lucky for me, they failed.
Now it's the bedroom. Oh, an apple.
Teachers are traditionally paid in apples. I got this one myself, because I didn't want to spend my first day without an apple.
Hmm. Paid in apples.
I wanted to ask the Archmage whether good teachers can expect any other form of payment than apples.
Hmm.
But when he showed me the beautiful contract with the seal and all that, it just didn't seem to be the right time to talk about gold.
Look.
This book looks very old and important. Half the class had runny noses. Most were recaptured.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
This is the roll book where the teacher writes down any unusual events. Plus 5 points for defeating a troll, minus 50 for leaving your dorm at night. Oh, maybe young Harry is right. That seems a little unbalanced. Whoa! School must have been more competitive back then.
It was called Hogwarts. Oh, I missed that. He said something.
The book is too thick to read without looking for anything in particular.
Okay.
The book is.
Every once in a while, he says something and, text flies by so quick I can't see it and he doesn't actually say anything. Oh, there's a wand here.
It didn't let me down this time, though. It worked even better than I
expected. Was my wand?
It was like it wanted to conjure. I could hardly keep it under control.
I didn't realize we didn't have it.
Sometimes my wand works perfectly and sometimes less so. I don't quite have the hang of it yet.
Alright, let's look at the apparatus.
Hmm, unusual. This device looks more like ordinary engineering than it does magic. Oh, most magical devices have lots of golden parts, elaborate decorations, and bells and whistles, just the way the mages like them. This one could easily come from a gnome workshop. What does it say? The apparatus that corrupted student Allardyce. A warning to those who do not want to accept the limits of magic. Hmm.
Where do I know the name Allardyce from? I'm really missing that.
It seems a student by the name of Allardyce made this apparatus and it brought him grief. I don't know why. Compared to the things lying around back home in Gnomehold, this apparatus doesn't look particularly dangerous.
So familiar.
What does it say? The apparatus of Wharton.
Look at the table. Well, that's a blackboard.
Ooh, crazy drawings and symbols. That must be really high magic. Only the wisest mages can understand all that.
Unless it doesn't mean anything. Look at the cages.
I suspect that some sort of strange magical creatures were kept in the cages. Students, for example. The little fellas look like they've got nothing but mischief in mind. I hope they don't get into too much trouble. They're ugly, but I summoned them. Therefore, there is a special bond between us.
There is? Where are you going?
They're ugly, but I summoned.
Okay, are we done? We're going back in our bedroom? Let's go back in our bedroom, I guess. I guess there's nothing new going on in here.
Master Marcus told me everything I need to know. I just wish I was.
Alright guys, I guess that's it for now. Join us back next time when we leave the classroom. See you then, and a bang bang boogie, and don't stop the boogie.